Hi, I'm Sereni from Design Plus Code. Welcome back on my fourth tutorial. So in this video, we're gonna create this pretty cool water animation inside of the crystal ball with prototype in Figma. What you will need is GetWave plugin, create your design, and then prototype. That's it, it's very simple. So let's get started. To make this wave easily and faster, I use GetWave plugin. If you don't have this plugin yet, you can go to the community and download plugin, tap GetWave, click on this plugin, make sure the plugin is from Richard Zimmerman, and then install it. GetWave plugin is a free SVG wave generator to make unique SVG wave for your design. You can custom your curve to make like round or rectangle or sharp. You can flip vertically. More you drag at the right side, more is make a high hill like a mountain. So it's very useful and really fast when you want to make your design. I use the wave for most of time on my background. To make this crystal ball, we will need the wave to make a water effect. And we will need the ellipse to make the background for this crystal. And we will need the reflection effect by using Boolean subtract to make a reflection. At the end, we're gonna add the background blur to make like a glass effect. So let's create a new one. Let's start by creating this ellipse. So we're gonna press O for the keyboard shortcut to make the ellipse like that. For the size, it's gonna be 430 by 430. So we're gonna add the radiant gradient because the shape is round. So I'm gonna choose the radial gradient to fit, to make like a bubble. So come and click on your layer, go to the palette color, click on fill, choose radiant color. Radiant color is start from the middle. So we're gonna take the first color, light blue. And the second color should be the blue. So next, we're gonna create the wave. If you already have the GetWave plugin, you can just right click, plugin, GetWave, and choose the round curve. Let's choose something more wavy. Let's say something like that. So when you are satisfied, you can just click on create. There you go. So we're gonna bring the wave inside this ellipse. How I gonna do that? But first of all, I'm gonna put the gradient color at the wave first. Come and click. I'm gonna choose linear gradient. I'm gonna skew a little bit like that. So the first color will be this color and the second will be the light blue. Next, I'm gonna bring the wave inside of the ellipse. How I gonna do that? First of all, we're gonna duplicate this ellipse by doing Command D for the shortcut. And the top layer, we're gonna mask. So right click, use as mask. But don't forget to bring the wave just on top of the mask, like this. We're gonna make a little bit smaller because it takes too much place. So it should be something like this. To make like a water effect, we're gonna duplicate the weight. So Command D, we're gonna flip horizontal and we're gonna bring a little bit at the left and we're gonna change color. You can play with the color. There you go. To make it brighter, we're gonna add a little reflection light like this one to make like shiny. So we're gonna mask. How we're gonna do that? Duplicate this ellipse two times. I'm gonna explain you after why I duplicate two times. Okay, the first one, make it invisible. Close the eyes of this layer. I would use this one to subtract with this layer. We're gonna use the Boolean group after that. Now I don't see anything, so we're gonna move this layer and change the color to see the difference. We're gonna add So this layer on the top, go at the left side a little bit, something like this, and then take the second layer on the back. We're gonna subtract the two layers together. So I want to cut everything from outside, and I just want to keep this shape like a moon. So I'm gonna go on the Boolean group and subtract selection. See, I subtract everything. So I can open back my eyes. I'm gonna name it right now. For now, we don't see the reflection because he's on the bottom of the mask. So bring at the top and make sure to be on the top of the wave, because if you put on the bottom of the wave, it's gonna hide. If you put there, it's gonna hide. So put on the top, and then we're gonna play with the color. So we're gonna add the solid color and decrease the opacity a little bit like that. And we're gonna move to make exactly the same thing. Make a reflection like a crystal effect. Then we're gonna duplicate the mask reflection, but this time we're gonna flip horizontal. Right click, flip horizontal, and bring it at the left side. It looks like that. Next, we're gonna create this big light reflection. We're gonna do the same thing, but this time we're gonna make it bigger. So to save your time, I can duplicate the same mask reflection and bring it on the top the layer. See how it looks. Bring a little bit at the middle. So we're gonna make it bigger. So enter, select the top layer, enter. Select all the 4 points and bring at the left, something like that. Now we're gonna add the layer blur. So add on the effect, layer blur, we're gonna put it at 7. And we're gonna add the light reflection like that. We can just create a circle, simple circle like this. Rotate a little bit, enter, and play with encore point. It's not exactly the same. You can just play a little bit and make another circle here. And then we're gonna add a solid color. We're gonna add the fill color on the reflection here. So come and click. Take the dropper. Take the blue color, decrease the opacity at 48, and do the same thing. I'm gonna copy property and pass property on this shape. It's gonna pass the same color like this. I'm gonna select both of the two layers. I'm gonna put 13% instead. It's gonna change both of them. Now we're gonna add the background blur on our crystal. So select the main ellipse, go on effect, select background blur, and I'm gonna put 50. I'm gonna decrease the opacity at 70%. I'm gonna add an inner shadow to see a little reflection. I'm gonna put it white and the opacity 25. So for the X portion, I'm gonna put 32, and the Y portion, I'm gonna put 9. And for the blur, it's gonna be 38. Let's play a little bit with this blur. I'm gonna make more blur, something like that. Maybe decrease a little bit. So I think it's great like this. 13, it's great. We are now ready to prototype. To finish my design, I just add some decoration like the bubble, the diamond, to make my design more fancy, more elegant, bring the design more to life. I use the background that I took on Safari to fit with my design with the crystal. You can create your own background if you want, but for me, I just want to fit with the crystal. I make this bubble with the contrast color. Why? Because as the crystal is with background blur, so I want to see the contrast with the glass effect. That's why I put the colorful background for this bubble. Let's try. You're gonna know what I mean. If I move the bubble, you can see the shape on the back. So this is background blur. So now let's put a type. When you are satisfied with your design, now we are ready to prototype with Smart Animate. Prototypes are a fantastic way to preview interaction and user flow. So we're gonna duplicate the frame, and then we're gonna change the second design on the second frame. Let's zoom out a little bit. So how it works, Smart Animate? We need two frames and two different designs. So the first one, your animation will start like this and should finish with different design. So let's make the wave differently. If the wave is at the left side, we're gonna change and bring it to the right side. So the water gonna move like this. And then I'm gonna do the same thing. If the wave is already at the right side, so I'm gonna bring at the left. It should be like this. Now we are ready to prototype. So the animation should start like this and finish like that. So select the first frame, click on prototype here. You see the connection node right here. We're gonna drag to the second frame like this. And for the interaction detail, we're gonna choose after delay. For the after delay, I'm gonna put 1 millisecond because I want the animation start right away. And for the animation, it's gonna be start animate. And for the duration, let's see with 1500 milliseconds. So I'm gonna do the same thing with the second frame. So we're gonna drag it back to the first frame. The animation should be connect together. So same thing, after delay, gonna put 1 millisecond, smart animate. For the duration, gonna be the same. So let's play the animation. Click on the play icon here. So voila, it's look like that. The water is moving inside the crystal ball. Is that crazy, guys? It's pretty cool, right? So that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed this quick tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, and give me a big thumbs up. So see you on the next video. Bye, guys.